please stand? Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Rita died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Please join in our opening hymn, Jerusalem, My Happy Home, verses 1, 2, 4, and 6.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Rita, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of good news. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Cry out, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom, leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
A reading from the first letter of John. For this is the message that you have heard from the beginning. We should love one another. We know that we have passed from death to life because we love our brothers. Whoever does not love remains in death. The way we came to know love was that he laid down his life for us. So we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You may be seated. Love is the most precious gift in life. Love gives us a sense of dignity and worth. It gives us a sense of belonging. It fills and completes us in a way that nothing else can. As children, God entrusted to our parents the great and noble task of showing us that love. It was through them that we first experienced that love, and that we came to understand what God's love was all about. And while both parents play important and necessary role in God's loving plan for our lives, the role of mother is unique. Even if we marry, even if we have children of our own, we will never again be as close to anyone in the way that we were to our mother. We will never again be as dependent on anyone as we were on mom. From the moment we were first conceived, our mother was literally our lifeline. Almost 7 decades ago, Rita became wife to her beloved husband, Edwin. In the years that followed, she became mom, the lifeline to her children, Marguerite Catherine, John, Rita, and Johanna. This morning, we've gathered in this church to celebrate the life and to honor the memory of her for whom the greatest accomplishment was being a faith-filled, devoted wife and a loving and caring mother. As well as being mom to 5, Rita was grandmother to 10 and great-grandmother to 8. Her motherly love shared through 3 generations, all so blessed to have had her as such an important part of their lives. So we've gathered here this morning in this church that Rita knew so well, this church where she came faithfully in praise of God, this church where she came daily to receive our Eucharistic Lord in Holy Communion, this church where she, along with Edwin, with the grace of God and the power of the Holy Spirit, formed their children in the beautiful, majestic, life-giving Catholic faith. We gather giving thanks to God for the gift of Rita's life, opening our hearts this morning to the comforting and uplifting words of sacred scripture. Words that are the healing balm for the sorrow and grief that have come with her passing. Words that speak of God's love for us, and how, having received that love, we are then to share it with one another. Words that bless us, as they did Rita, with their inspiration and beauty. In our first reading, the prophet Isaiah speaks words of tenderness, encouragement, and hope to the heartbroken people of Judah, some who were driven from their homeland, living in exile in Babylon, others living among the ruins of their beloved city, Jerusalem. God is spoken of by Isaiah in terms of one of the most beloved images we have of him, that of the Good Shepherd, feeding his flock, gathering the lambs in his arms, leading the ewes with care. That same image of our loving God as the Good Shepherd appears in our psalm response. The 23rd Psalm, the Good Shepherd Psalm, perhaps the most beautiful and beloved of all the Psalms. These comforting and inspiring words were not just meant to be meaningful and transformative to the lives of the people who lived thousands of years ago in times of sorrow. They are meant for us here today to encourage us, to comfort and console us in the midst of our sorrow. God knows what we are feeling and wants us to know that we aren't forgotten and that we haven't been abandoned. God is with us, gathering us in his arms, leading us through our sorrow and grief. Such love God bestows on us in abundance throughout our lives. The beloved disciple, the Apostle John, in our second reading, speaks of how great God's love should work in and through us. The way we came to know love was that he laid down his life for us, John writes. So we ought to lay down our lives for our brothers. In other words, we are to offer our lives in loving sacrifice to our God and to our neighbor, whoever that neighbor may be, and however we may encounter him or her. Rita knew love in this way, not only in her love for her family, but in her love for the thousands of students whom she came to know during her decades in administration at Oak Hill Elementary. She lived this love of neighbor during her many years at St. Edward, through her work in the St. Vincent de Paul Society, the Migrant Worker Ministry, and in all the other ways she reached out to those on the margins, those who are too often overlooked and underserved. In our gospel reading this morning from the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus preaches the new law of love of the new covenant, not commandments, but beatitudes. Those blessings that we experience that will, even if they may not appear to in a given moment, bring us the happiness that only God can give. In the Beatitudes, Jesus is telling us how we should live, embracing life in all the ways that we can experience it, and also how we should understand the ways in which we're blessed, even through pain and suffering, even through sorrow and hardship that life can bring. Living the Beatitudes that Jesus proclaimed brought Rita the things that are most worthwhile in this life: peace, joy, love, mercy, comfort, compassion, gentleness, integrity, and freedom of spirit. Not only in her life, but also in the lives of so many others with whom she shared the fruits of these blessings. In her life here, according to the Beatitudes, Rita was already living as one belonging to the kingdom of heaven. Eternity, everlasting life, which she now knows, is achieving the fullness of life in God's heavenly kingdom. And that's what we rejoice in for Rita today. Rita's earthly life of faith and love came to its end during this season of Advent, this season of preparation, anticipation, and waiting for the coming of the Lord. This holy season, when we once again joyfully celebrate the coming that occurred at Jesus' birth, when we welcome the coming of Jesus more deeply every day into our hearts and into our lives, and when we prepare for the day when Jesus comes again, either with the sound of a trumpet blast and power and glory, or silently and gently on the day he calls us home. We know Rita celebrated many Advent seasons in her life. Many of them were here in this community and in this parish. On December 12th, the day the church celebrates the Feast of Our Lady of Guadalupe, well into her final Advent season, and after years of bravely facing the heavy burdens brought on by dementia, Rita's time of preparation had reached its end. It was time for the Lord to take her by the hand and to lead her home. She had fulfilled her duties, obligations, and responsibilities as a devoted wife from the first days of her marriage to Edwin, standing by his side, loving and supporting him in his work and in the most important role of his life, fatherhood. To the last days, caring for him for many years after he suffered the effects of a debilitating stroke. She had also completed her duties, obligations, and responsibilities as a loving mother, always nurturing her children in a supportive and encouraging home and instilling in them the importance of faith in God and in their Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And she had perhaps most importantly, fulfilled her duties, obligations, and responsibilities as a believer in God and as a disciple of Jesus Christ to build up the kingdom of heaven on earth. And she did it joyfully and in many different ways. All of those ways of loving sacrifice and service and so many more were the hallmark of Rita's life. A life gratefully received as a gift from God and a life then lovingly given back to God and to others. The time of Rita's life with us, a life so rich and so full, has come to an end. She has taken the last step on a journey, a pilgrimage that we too will all one day take, passing over from this life to life eternal. But even in her passing, Rita's presence will still be felt. It will be felt in the legacy that she leaves behind, the legacy of faith and family, the legacy of all of you who were touched by Rita, you who were formed by Rita, you who were loved by Rita so much. You'll now carry her life in yours. You'll do it in the way you by the way you imitate her good example, and in all the ways that through you, she will continue to impact your families, your parishes, and the communities that you call home. So even though there is cause for great sorrow and great grief today, there is also cause for joyful celebration. We celebrate Rita's wonderful life on this earth. We celebrate her love for her family and for this parish and this community during the many years in which this was her home. And we celebrate the hope and the gift of life eternal. That's where the joy comes in today, even amidst the sadness and sorrow. Rita gave you so much during her life. Now, in her passing, she leaves you with many, many precious memories. Hold on to them. Treasure them. And when you do, you'll celebrate her life and honor her legacy. A good woman, a loving wife and mother, and a faithful and devoted disciple has been called home by the Lord. And while we grieve her passing, we give thanks to God for the gift of her beautiful, joyful, and faithful life. Well done, good and faithful servant. Well done. Please stand. Now, as the children come forward, brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. To each of the petitions the children will offer, please respond, "Lord, hear our prayer."
For Rita, may she enjoy eternal life and the promises of Christ in heaven as one who loved greatly and who knew love in return. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for the gift of our families and friends gathered here today out of love for Rita, may we continue to grow in our love for each other and our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who mourn the loss of a loved one, may they feel the consolation of God's tender mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the dearly departed members of the Reynolds, Duggan, Suker, and Rothgary families, especially Edwin Francis Reynolds, husband of Rita Reynolds, may eternal rest be granted unto them, and may perpetual light shine upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those living with dementia and Alzheimer's disease, may they, their families, and health professionals experience God's love, strength, and peace throughout the difficult journey. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater reverence and respect for human life, from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. My apologies, I didn't realize two of the children were were adults. Grandchildren, okay. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated as the altar is prepared and the gifts are brought forward. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Rita, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of glory.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Rita, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share a sign of peace.
Hey, thank you, sweetie. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
One, two, three.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of the Eucharist this morning, Deacon Bob and I will be on each side of the main aisle of the font. We ask that you just come forward from the main aisle, through the main aisle. If you are not able to receive the Eucharist, if you are a Catholic and not able to receive, or if you are a different Christian faith tradition, and sadly we are not in full communion with each other, if you would like to come forward to receive a blessing, we just ask that you come forward with your arms crossed.
Make of our
Lord, make us one with you.
Wisdom, teach us love. You were
Rita's son John is going to come forward to share some thoughts, reflections, memories about his mother. John?
Well, I think Graham would have loved Lucy's presentation. Lucy, you had it going on. Good job. I'd like to thank all of you for coming here today to join us in this celebration of my mom Rita's Mass of the Resurrection, and particular thanks to Father Rick and the St. Edward's community and each and every one of you. Mom loved every one of you, each and every one of you. I know she'd be so pleased to see you, her precious family and friends, in this holy place to celebrate our life together with her in Christ. Mom's love enfolded all of us, and she showed it in so many ways. Her deep and abiding faith was at the core of her great capacity to love. As she knew love, she shared love in her many roles as daughter, sister, wife and mother, grandmother, aunt, cousin, friend, and in her professional and community life. She gave without counting the cost and in so many ways. Her care for my father, Ed, after 13 years of debilitating recovery after a stroke was a model of true marital love and fidelity. She never asked, why me? She never complained about life's challenges. She met them head on. She lovingly cared for aging relatives with tender continence and patience. For us, her children, her love was boundless. She tended carefully to our needs and most importantly guided us in our faith formation. She made our meals, our clothes, Halloween and Christmas outfits, and celebrated our sacramental and educational milestones, achievements, and marriages with exuberance and great love. She simply showed up. She was not afraid to challenge us when we needed it and encourage us to do good things with our God-given talents. Encouraging her five children to attend university, she made it possible for us to dream large. In our extended family life, Mom brought both sides of our family and our friends together with countless celebrations. This is such an important, lasting legacy of our parents' generation. It's what brings you here to honor her today. When I gaze at my father's precious 35-millimeter Kodachrome images of these events, her hand is everywhere in the frame. The clothes we wore, the food we ate, the decorations that graced our homes. She was an artist and maker, seamstress and chef, and these objects grace all our homes as they witness to her loving presence in our lives. Mom loved the underdog. She was there for the farm migrant, the elderly, the poor, the disabled, and dispossessed at the margins, and especially the overlooked or mischievous child. She enjoyed her professional life at AT&T and the Thompson Clinic, but her lasting legacy was assisting Jack Foss in running Oak Hill Elementary School. I treasured my impromptu visits to the office and listening to her and Jack manage school affairs with efficiency, compassion, and humor. And I know it dates me, but Mom and Jack were definitely Colonel Blake and Radar for all of you that remember the MASH sitcom. They completed each other's sentences, and it was wonderful. And when it was time for retirement, they retired together. It's beautiful, beautiful vignette. But one instance stands to mind that still makes me laugh. A little fellow was sitting in the miscreant chair opposite Mom's desk, and she whispered to him really quietly as I was there, and she said, she put in a good word with Jack on his behalf, and that it would only be 5 or 10. And the little guy's eyes widened. He must have wondered 10 lashes or 10 years instead of 10 minutes on the famous white bench. So Mom lipped across her desk to assure this little guy that it was only 10 minutes on the white bench. Mom leaned into life. Although not a teacher by trade, she loved education and treasured her reenactment classroom at the Buckley Homestead. She was adventuresome and in retirement traveled from Lowell to Denali via the Alaskan Highway in a conversion van with neighbor Barb Cunningham. She visited my family in Luxembourg and dived into European culture and habit. Although a Chicago girl by birth, she grew to treasure Lowell and her life at St. Edward as an active member of the parish, St. Vincent de Paul conference member, and daily communicant. A trip to Costas or Wilco to pick up a few items was always a half an hour, as the former alums of Oak Hill would greet her to update her on their lives and families. Her mental Rolodex was astonishing as she could recall their names and key events in their life at school. While at home in Lowell, she never forgot her roots in Brighton Park, her grade school days at St. Agnes, her high school years at Kelly High School, and post-secondary study in business administration and accounting. She kept up with family and friends in the old neighborhood, often at their service. Mom deeply loved her extended family by marriage, her in-laws, nieces, and nephews, and one never sensed any distinction as to whose side of the family was who. Whether Reynolds, Duggan, Suker, or Rothgeary, we are and will remain one family. And so many vivid instances of that. I think of coming to my Uncle Wally's wake, and the first person that greeted me was Paul Duggan. And that just tells you a lot about what our parents did for us that we can never repay. Her twilight years brought the challenges posed by advancing dementia. Despite these challenges, she remained fiercely independent and bore her condition with humility, grace, and at times uncanny humor. She always remembered her prayers and was always up for a rousing version of Doris Day's A Bushel and a Peck. Whether in Cincinnati, Columbus, or under the watchful and caring eyes of Johanna in Sunnyvale, Katie in Seattle, and most recently in Maryland with Rita, she inspired us with her wisdom, tenacity, and sheer grit, while always remaining a strong yet gentle matriarch. In my last visit with her just over a week ago, her eyes still shone their steely blue brightness as she wordlessly patted my hand to acknowledge that despite the fog of dementia, she could still communicate a mother's love for her child, hand to hand, heart to heart. This is her legacy, her gift to us. Let us long remember her now and forever. So thank you all. And Johanna reminded me to remind all of you that we have an interment at St. Ed's Cemetery just a few minutes away. And just 3 minutes away or so from the cemetery, route to the signature, we have a nice luncheon prepared and all are invited. So thank you all. We love you all.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Rita may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Rita. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Commend the soul of Rita, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sins she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister Rita to her place of rest. Rita, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation. I hear the real, the far off hymn. Love is Lord of heaven and earth.
mind says, I am His.